Hello, namaste everybody. So before starting lesson, let me begin with the question. Which one of the given fraction is larger, 1 by 2 or it's 1 by 3? So many of you might answer me 1 by 2, but some of you might think it may be 1 by 3 also, because here we can see 3 is greater than 2, isn't it? So here, instead of asking like this, if I had asked by this figure, so by making this figure, if I had asked here, which one is greater, 1 by 2 or 1 by 3? Here the red portion, the red sector, is 1 by 2, red colored one, and the blue colored is 1 by 3. And by observing the picture, we can easily visualize that we get a clear picture in our mind that 1 by 2 is definitely greater than 1 by 3. So how to make such sector, we have discussed it earlier in the previous video. So if you want to know how to prepare the sector, then you can watch my previous video. But here in this section, I'll be discussing about comparison of fractions using GeoGebra. So how we can compare the fractions using GeoGebra. So let's have a discussion. So let me say it is 1 by 5, and the next one is, let it be 2 by 7. Okay. So here, which one is greater? Is it 1 by 5 or 2 by 7? So in such questions, we have done such calculations. So here, what we do is, first of all, we find the LCM of 5 and 7. Then our LCM is 35. So if 35 is divided by 5, then we get 7. So we multiply both numerators and denominators by the common multiple, that is 7. So, and similarly here, if 35 is divided by 7, then we get 5. And here, if we multiply both numerators as well as denominator by 5, then we get 10 by 35. So in this way, we have solved the problem, and we have said that 2 by 7 is greater than 1 by 5. But instead of just doing the calculations only, if we visualize it using the figure, then definitely it will be easier for us to elaborate, isn't it? Because here in the figure, you can see the blue color sector is obviously greater than the red color one. So here, using GeoGebra, we can compare the fraction, we can tease how to compare fraction to the students. Not only addition and subtraction, it can be used for the comparison of fraction also. So if you want to make a sector, if you are still unknown how to make sectors in circle using GeoGebra, then you can watch my previous video. So in the next video, I'll be soon back with another formula, how to calculate the curved surface area of cylinder. But for today, it's time to sign off. So have a nice time. Bye.